Let's continue examining DEEDAT's combat kit. We're almost through with his absurd jihad of absurdity in section 4. J. Samson has sex with a whore in Gaza. Judges 16, verse 1. K. Ruth cohabits with Boaz in the barn. Ruth, chapter 3, verse 4 through 15. L. David sleeps with a young virgin. 1 Kings 1, verses 1 and 3. If the last three, G, H, and I, were the Islamic toilet jihad, these three must be the adult book section of the absurd jihad of absurdity. Have you been keeping count? 9 accusations, and not one is valid, honest, or true. It honestly reflects all that is good about Islam and Islamic thinking. Nothing. Nada. Zero. Zip. Zilch. It's an ofer. Samson has sex with a whore in Gaza. Judges 16:1. One day Samson went to Gaza, where he saw a prostitute, and went in to spend the night with her. That's it. DEEDAT calls that absurd. A powerful alpha male sleeping with a prostitute. Or in fact, it says he went in to spend the night with her. Muhammad had not yet invented prostitution by another name, muta. Temporary marriage in the Quran for sex at an agreed payment after a day or two. This word, absurd, I do not think it means what DEEDAT thinks it means. Perhaps he should have examined Islam's form of prostitution the Quran approves. When the Gazites heard that Samson was there, they surrounded that place and lay in wait for him all night at the city gate. They were quiet throughout the night, saying, "Let us wait until dawn. Then we will kill him." Huh, you know where your enemy is? He's distracted with a prostitute and preoccupied. So you decide to wait until dawn, perhaps 6, 7, 8 hours, before attacking. I'd say that strategy was absurd. But Samson lay there only until midnight. Now notice, it doesn't actually say they did the deed. He just lay there with a prostitute. Just saying. But waiting is not such a good plan. When he got up, he took hold of the doors of the city gate and both gateposts and pulled them out, bar and all. Then he put them on his shoulders and took them to the top of the mountain overlooking Hebron. Not only did Samson leave, but he stole the front door of the city gates. Yet this is not what DEEDAT calls absurd. DEEDAT is upset a great man of the Bible is recorded to have had sex with a prostitute. This speaks volumes of Islam's willingness to lie to make its prophet, Muhammad, look good. As I was researching this, I wondered if Samson was married when he used the prostitute. Now there, the story starts to get interesting. Judges 14:1. One day Samson went down to Timnah, where he saw a young Philistine woman. This is chapter 14, two chapters before 16:1 that DEEDAT attempts to criticize. So he returned and told his father and mother, "I have seen a daughter of the Philistines in Timnah. Now get her for me as a wife. I saw. I want." But his father and mother replied, "Can't you find a young woman among your relatives or among any of our people? Must you go to the uncircumcised Philistines to get a wife?" But Samson told his father, "Get her for me, for she is pleasing to my eyes." Now his father and mother did not know this was from the Lord, who was seeking an occasion to move against the Philistines, for at that time the Philistines were ruling over Israel. Beep, beep, back up the truck. This was from the Lord, who was seeking an occasion to move against the Philistines. Huh. Samson's overwhelming desire for this Philistine woman was from God. Because the Lord, Jehovah God, was looking to create an excuse, an occasion, to move against the Philistines. The subtle significance of this clearly skipped Dedat's absurdometer. Then Samson went down to Timnah with his father and mother, and came to the vineyards of Timnah. Suddenly a young lion came roaring at him. They're going to get him a bride at Timnah, and, oh, darn, a lion! And the Spirit of the Lord came powerfully upon him, and he tore the lion apart with his bare hands, as one would tear a young goat. I just love how casually it says, as one would tear a young goat. To pieces, apart, limb from limb. Some days I can barely tear open a bag of potato chips. But he did not tell his father or mother what he had done. So Samson was alone, and no one knew what he had done. Then Samson continued on his way down and spoke to the woman, because she was pleasing to his eyes. And ladies have known for 3,000 years that men are motivated, enticed, even controlled by what they see. When Samson returned later to take her, he left the road to see the lion's carcass, and in it was a swarm of bees, along with their honey. He returned later. Some time must have passed, because it takes a while for bees to create combs filled with honey. So he scooped some honey into his hands and ate it as he went along. And when he returned to his father and mother, he gave some to them, and they ate it. But he did not tell them that he had taken the honey from the lion's carcass. Samson is still the only person on earth who knows of the lion he killed and the honey that was now in it. Then his father went to visit the woman, and Samson prepared a feast there, as was customary for the bridegroom. And when the Philistines saw him, they selected 30 men to accompany him. Keep the number 30 in mind. Let me tell you a riddle, Samson said to them. If you can solve it for me within the 7 days of the feast, I will give you 30 linen garments and 30 sets of clothes. 7 day wedding feast. Bridegroom coming for his bride. Nudge, wink. Say no more, say no more. But if you cannot solve it, you must give me 30 linen garments and 30 sets of clothes. Tell us your riddle, they replied. Let us hear it. So he said to them, out of the eater came something to eat, and out of the strong came something sweet. For 3 days they were unable to explain the riddle. So on the fourth day they said to Samson's wife, entice your husband to explain the riddle to us, or we will burn you and your father's household to death. Did you invite us here to rob us? They're upset, and they go after the young woman, his Philistine bride, to help them undermine or cheat Samson. Then Samson's wife came to him, weeping, and said, you hate me. You do not really love me. You have posed to my people a riddle, but have not explained it to me. Look, he said, I have not even explained it to my father or mother. So why should I explain it to you? Strategically, I see this as problematic. The Bible says a man should leave his mother and father and cleave to his wife. Samson appears to still prioritize his mom and dad over his new wife. I'll tell mom and dad before I tell you. She wept the whole 7 days of the feast, and finally on the seventh day, because she had pressed him so much, he told her the answer. And in turn, she explained the riddle to her people. Dedat was so blind, he missed a perfect place to attempt to form an actual criticism. She wept the whole 7 days, but the Philistines only threatened her on the fourth day. The implication was she was crying about the whole marriage from day one. She wept the whole 7 days of the feast. And finally on the seventh day, because she had pressed him so much, he told her the answer. And in turn, she explained the riddle to her people. This does not bode well for this marriage. Before sunset on the seventh day, the men of the city said to Samson, What is sweeter than honey, and what is stronger than a lion? So he said to them, If you had not plowed with my heifer, you would not have solved my riddle. You cheated, and the only way you could have was to get the answer from my wife. This is where the story takes an interesting turn. Then the Spirit of the Lord came mightily upon him. God's Spirit. God's Holy Spirit moves mightily upon Samson. Remember how this chapter began? In Judges 14:4, this was from the Lord who was seeking an occasion to move against the Philistines. Then the Spirit of the Lord came mightily upon him, and he went down to Ashkelon, killed 30 of their men, took their apparel, and gave their clothes to those who had solved the riddle. And burning with anger, Samson returned to his father's house. So Samson gives 30 sets of clothes to the men from the 30 Philistines he had just killed and stripped naked. I wonder if they or their wives were able to get the blood out. Do you hear, cheaters never prosper, cheaters never prosper, echoing in your ears? But that is not yet the end of the story. And his wife was given to one of the men who had accompanied him, which sounds a lot like the marriage was over, even before it really began. But it's not. It actually just feeds into the events of chapter 15. In that chapter, the wife ends up being killed by the Philistines. So Samson is in fact single again when the encounter of 16:1 occurs. Samson has sex with a whore in Gaza. One day Samson went to Gaza where he saw a prostitute and went in to spend the night with her. We've already seen Samson was influenced by his eyes. When he saw a beautiful woman, he was rash and got married. But even that was within God's plan to find occasion to deal with the Philistines. The scriptures are not stories of great men to make us worship those men. The revelation of God exists to reveal God. The men are not the focus. All scripture is given and inspired by God to teach what he once taught. 2 Timothy 3:16. All scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. Sometimes that's bad examples we are to learn what not to do. Samson was not perfect. However, it is not absurd to record the fact that Samson, a single alpha male, may have used a prostitute. What is absurd is for the man Muhammad to make up a fairy tale revelation to have more wives than every other Muslim who obeys him. And it is absurd that Muslims accept the baseless lies of this one man, making himself Allah over them. If you are Muslim, do you ever think about Muhammad making rules for you that he himself did not have to obey? This video about an absurd accusation by DDAT went a different direction and went longer than I thought. I'll get to the next DDAT absurdity in the next video. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.